Guys, welcome back to another video on this channel. This is my second video where I am going to show you guys how I edit my pictures for Instagram. I hope you guys can take some inspiration out of it and most importantly, enjoy. Okay, so here I just cropped my image with a 4x5 crop, which you can choose when you're cropping your image, and I'm trying to make my picture look as horizontal as possible. Now I'm just trying to adjust some details, sharpen the image a little bit, and to reduce some noise you can find in the darker areas of the plane. Now I just want to say something on those details because I'm not always using the same amount of sharpening or noise reduction. That's just something that's different for every picture, and you just have to look for yourself what you like. Alright, so now I'm just doing some basic color adjustments. I'm looking at the yellow and the greens, but later on I'll be looking at the shadows and the blacks. Now I'll zoom in on the windows because I don't really like how there's a slight blue shine on the right window, and I'm also just going to make them a little bit more black because I don't really like it when shadows are too bright. Okay, so here I found another area with too much noise, which I'm going to delete by decreasing the texture and just reducing some noise in the brush options. Now I'm just going to do the same on the other side of the plane. Okay, so I am very happy with how the edit turned out, but did you know we just edited the plane and not the background? We didn't even talk about the background. Now I'm going to export it as a TIFF file. That's very important, you need to export it as a TIFF. That's what we're going to use later on in Photoshop. Okay, now I'm going back to the moment where I finished my lens corrections. This is very important. Don't click on reset picture on the bottom right corner because otherwise you're also losing your crop, and that's not what we want. So now you can just edit the background without minding the plane, and yeah, just also export it as a TIFF file when you're satisfied with your background.
Beat it, I'm invincible.
Okay, so now I opened up Photoshop and I'm just going to import my foreground and my background into Photoshop to mesh them up. You can do that by different ways, but I'm always doing it the way I'm going to show you because that's the most precise way to me. When you want to select two pictures, you just have to hold the for Mac command and for Windows control key and click on the two photos you want to import. Also, when you are deleting the contours of the plane, you have to use the eraser tool, and to make it go faster, you can use the shift key. When you've done that, use the selection tool to select the whole plane. You just have to stay inside the already deleted white lines, and then at the end you'll be satisfied with a precise deleted plane. Now you've successfully combined both edits. I think I'm not very satisfied with how the edit turned out, so I guess I'm just going to do some other basic adjustments on the camera raw filter, and later on I'll be showing another option you can use if your image is a bit unsharp. So you don't need to sharpen it in Lightroom, but you can sharpen it way better with way more quality in Photoshop. Okay, so now I'm going to do the sharpening method I've already talked about and just do what I do because I don't know the terms in English. My Photoshop is set in Dutch, so yeah, just do what I do. Now press Ctrl, Alt, Shift and E, so Photoshop is going to mesh up the layers you selected with the Shift key. This sharpening method can cause quite a lot of noise, so you can just reduce the noise with another filter in Photoshop. Now I'm going to export the final image out of Photoshop. Before I'm ending the video, I will really appreciate it if you will like this video and subscribe to my channel. That would be really awesome and helpful. I'd like to thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. I will say later, my aviator.